Hollywood and Vine is a myth. That you go to Hollywood and Vine from somewhere in the world, in America, and be discovered by an agent and become a star. It's got a good dose of decadence, kind of a fallen grandeur. Hollywood and Vine today is a memory of the golden age. There's all these neon signs and that weird breathy stench of cigarette and booze. And then there's that smell that comes off the hills in the evening of night blooming jasmine. This is a brand that really comes alive at night. It's not really a daytime brand. This is a brand that says, stay up all night, write poetry, have a great meal, make love, you know. Sleep till noon with your sunglasses on in bed, you know, and get ready for the next night. It's that place, spiritually. I'm Matthew Rolston. My primary occupation is idea person. My definition of what I do is general, because what I do is diverse. I would say that I exist professionally at kind of a crossroads of all the things I'm interested in. Design, photography, lighting, filmmaking, glamour, beautiful women, interior design. And those are all brought together in a project like this. My job as brand director for this project called the Redbury began with an open slate. I was asked to develop everything, from the naming to the mission statement, from the colors to the uniforms to the design on every level. So it's a real 360 visioning process. It's not just one thing.
Most of our conversations early on was Matthew just listening to what our needs were. And once he listened, he came back very methodically and visually took our whole team to where he wanted to end up in a relatively very quick amount of time. A creative director stands more kind of on really at my level. It's really the person who can imagine where we want to end up before we even start.
Look where we are, Hollywood and Vine. Look what's across the street, Capitol Records building. And I looked at the building, and I just got townhouse. Very quickly, image of a kind of hippie townhouse. So as soon as I started thinking about American music of the late 60s, of course, I thought of Haight-Ashbury, which was the epicenter of the psychedelic movement. But there is an Ashbury Hotel someplace in the world. After much experimentation with other names, was Redbury. Sort of red plus Ashbury equals Redbury. The first thing I do is I have an inkling of an idea, like I did for this place, and I just start instinctively gathering visuals. I print it all very small, and I sit on the floor in a big space, and I just start playing with it. And I start to put image systems together instinctively. I don't even know what they mean yet. And they start to tell me stories. The pictures tell me the stories.
I needed to trust Matthew that this product was going to work. We worked very, very well hand in hand, and there was a very, I think, at least from my standpoint, a mutual respect for him and letting him do what he's great at. We always looked at it as if Matthew came in with a big syringe and just injected it with soul, and that's ultimately what ended up happening.
It's very, very much like directing one of my commercials or music videos. Instead of my usual production team, which would be an art director, well, here I had an architect. Instead of a set dresser, well, here I had an interior designer. Instead of a costume company, I had a uniform company. Instead of a graphics house doing the post graphics for a commercial or a music video, I work with a graphics house to develop all the collateral, to develop the logo, the type forms, the style book for the project, all of it.
Who is Matthew Rolston? Well, he's obviously a creative genius. He's inspiring, he's fun, he's happy, and he's a really nice person. We've had an amazing experience at SBE working with Matthew. You know, I'm sure we'll continue to work with him closely in the future.
Matthew doesn't look at things necessarily from an interior designer's perspective. He looks at it a little bit more creatively and trying to create more of a holistic approach to the stay, what it is, who our customers are going to be, because it's all about creating a vibe and an energy.
We wanted it to be like if you could have borrowed your friend's really great apartment in Hollywood when they're out of town and they happen to be in the music business and have great taste.
Well, I think the Redbury really feels like you're stepping into one of Matthew's creations. Every once in a while you have that lightning in a bottle experience, and this was one of those experiences.
You know, I built and imagined so many environments for photographs and for videos and commercials. But then, within minutes of finishing shooting them, we're tearing it down, throwing it all away. Well, here it is. It's still here. And it's a stage set every single night. And it's very satisfying to come back here and see people enjoying it.